data warehousing. Data warehousing means, according to Rolf Kimball, data warehousing is used for the only for analysis the business. It is not for run the business. So after that, another one, W.H. Chinmam is given the valuable and valid definition. Data warehousing is subject oriented, integrated, time variant and non-volatile database. It is used for the top level management. That is the definition given by the W.H. Chinmark. And the characteristics of the data warehousing is also subject oriented, integrated and time variant. These are called the characteristics of the data warehousing. So now let us explain about the characteristics, each and every characteristics. It's first one, subject oriented. Subject oriented means organization around major subjects such as customer, product, sales. So if you take the information from customer, you need to get information. And product, what is the, which product is sold, the sales revenue, the huge sales revenue is generated from which product. Those things we will learn clearly from this subject oriented. Suppose if you take the bank, different loan departments is there. Personal loan, crop loan, education loan, home loans like that. So the manager will see all the things. But each and every loan manager, suppose personal loan manager will see only the personal loans and the home loan manager will see the only home loans. So here what we explain means each and every individual subjects or individual categories also it is possible to analyze is. That is called subject oriented. For example, take any college. So take our college, we have the different branches, CSE, ECE, EEE and civil mechanical like that. So each branch has the one HOD. HOD will take care of the individual department. And the principal or above the principal directors are, and these people will take care about the all the departments. So they will see each and every department. They will take care of each and every department. So we need to different individual departments data. You can easily get because this data warehousing deals with the different subject oriented like that. So provide a simple and concise view around the particular subject issues by excluding data and that not used for the, it is not used to run the business. If you want to analyze the business, it is very good. So that is called subject oriented. And next one is integrated, subject oriented, integrated. So integrated means actually the data is getting from the different resources. Different resources means once you can integrate and finalize it, you will get the data analysis. So that's why data warehousing is integrated. It is sometimes relational databases. The resources will be relational databases, flat files, COBOL files, or any text files or any other files. We need to integrate all the data and we will get the, finally we will load into this, into the data warehousing. So that is the second characteristic. A data warehousing is subject oriented and integrated. It is integrated means combination of all constructed by integrating multiple heterogeneous data sources. That is called integration. Heterogeneous means relational DBMSs, databases, flat files, online records, online transactions, and COBOL files. These all are the individual heterogeneous. So heterogeneous data set, these resources have different structures. We will store those into the one thing. So before storing, we need to apply the pre-processing techniques, data cleaning, data integration, and data transformation. The three cleaning techniques we need to apply. Excuse me. Next one is time variant. So time variant means it will be varies with the time. So how it will be varies with the time means, suppose operation data stores maintain only current value data, and data warehousing data provides the information historical data. That is main thing. It can maintain 5 to 10 years data, historical data. The data will be useful if you are using any. We need to get the information, previous data information, that is also possible with this previous data. So it will maintain the history of the data, that is very, very important. Time variant, that is. And also we need to get the information from, suppose we want to generate the reports for per year. So how we can generate the report per year? In databases or in DBMS, we need to generate the report. So you need to write a query. What is the sales revenue generated for a product in a particular year? That's why. But similarly, immediately you will ask the data generated for 6 months. What is the sales revenue generated for 6 months? Or immediately you can ask the, what is the sales revenue generated for the quarterly? Quarterly means every 3 months. Or what is the sales revenue generated for a particular product in the month, month sales revenue. Or if you want 1 week, or if you want 1 day, or if you want 1 hour. So like this, if you want to ask the data for immediately this type of transactions, this is possible. In data warehousing, it is possible. We are using the ETL tools, extraction, transformation, and loading. It is also possible to get the information. That is the main thing. So that is time variant. It is varies with the time. And the next one is time variant and non-volatile. So first of all, we need to take volatile. Volatile means keeps on changing. So in databases, if you have entered the new data, the old data will be terminated. Or it will maintain at least 6 months, that's all. After 6 months, we cannot get the old data. So that will be erased and new data will be added. So, but here it will maintain the historical data, non-volatile. It does not change. Volatile means keeps on changing. Non-volatile means does not change, because it can maintain the historical data. That is the main thing. Whenever you want, you can compare, and the analysis purpose is very easy. That is called the non-volatile. So now the definition, WHIMMON given the exact definition for data warehousing. Data warehousing is subject-oriented, integrated, time-variant, and non-volatile database. So this is the thing. Next thing is, so this data warehousing, yesterday we explained about the benefits of the data warehousing. Now we need to explain the difference between database and data warehousing. Database is also called OLTP, online transactional processes. Online transactional process means this OLTP is used to transactional purpose only. Transactional means it is only for the running the each and every transaction, not for analysis the data. Okay. So we need to run the business. So here OLTP means that is the main thing. OLAP means data warehousing. It is used to analysis the data. So it is used for the top level management. And this database design in OLTP is ER diagrams, but in data warehouses, OLAP means it is a multi-dimensional model. Now, multi-dimensional model. It is dimensional view. Dimensional view. Each and every dimensional, we need to get the data. Data warehousing is like that. So in OLTP, it cannot maintain the historical data. Just it will maintain that detailed data, but data warehousing maintain the historical data, consolidated data is also. So suppose if OLTP means it is a databases, operation databases. Operation databases is used by the end users, users or database administrators. These level employees will be used for the databases, but OLTP will be used by the top level management. Only the higher level people will analyze the data and will take the appropriate decisions. That is the major issue. So next thing is, and access pattern means we need to update the data here, and in data warehouses the queries we need to read the data, read only data. Sometimes this data warehousing is also called read only database. We need not to change. You can analyze the data and you can estimate. You can give the one report whether the whether the store or any shop or anything is, whether it is in a profit or whether it will be in a loss. That thing you can predict and you can estimate it and you will give it to them compared to the previous data. So that is the main thing. And next is now next differences. So separate store data transform from operational environment. Operational update data does not occur in the data. So before going to store with the data warehousing, there is an operational data store will be there. That is also called so in operational updated does not occur in the data warehousing environment. Here we will get the data. So data does not require transactional process and recovery and concurrency control mechanism. Requires only two operation in data as initial loading of the data and accessing data. So in data warehousing or so this is used for analysis purpose only, but OLTP means majorly depending upon transactional purpose. And see the differences. So here OLTP versus OLUP. So users, who are the users for OLTP? OLTP users are clerks, IT professionals. These are comes under the OLTP users. Now this is very, very important. Every time they will ask the question is, what is the difference between OLTP and OLAP? Or OLTP versus OLAP, explain. Or they will ask for explain the difference between database and data warehousing. Or explain the difference between operational databases and data warehousing. Or operational databases and online analytical processing. Like that they are asking. So this is very, very important question. Just you need to write this table, it is good. So here users are in OLTP, it is used for transactional purpose. Clerks, IT professionals, these people only use this. In OLAP, knowledge workers means the top level management of the top level employees of the organization, they are using the OLAP. Why? Because after observing all these transactions, they need to conclude one decision. Whether if it is organization is in a profit way or organization is in a loss, they are analyzing, and the steps need to develop or need to improve the business. They will take the appropriate step. That's why it is used only for the top level management, OLAP. Knowledge workers or top level management will take the decisions and will analyze. So next, functioning, how the OLTP will functioning. OLTP will functioning the day-to-day operations. But OLAP means decision support. Decision support means it will maintain the historical data. According to that historical data, they will take the decisions. Who will take? The top level management will be take the decisions. That is the main thing. And database design. So this database design for OLTP is application oriented. OLAP is subject oriented. Just now we discussed about the subject oriented. It is one of the characteristics of the data warehouse. Individual subjects also, you need to get the data and you need to generate for the individual subjects. That is very, very important. Next, data. The in OLTP, what type of data is there? Different types of the data will be there. Flat files is there, databases, database files is there. Updated data will be there. Only current data. The current data will be available in the OLTP. But in the OLAP, the historical data is available and it is also with the multi-dimensional data. Multi-dimensional data will be used here. And next one, usage. What is the usage means? This OLTP means a repetitive data will be there. Suppose if you want to give the employee bonus, so at the starting employee salary is 5,000. After 1 year, it will be increased to some more another 5,000. So like that, the changes will be there. The changes will be noted here, day to day evaluation or something monthly or for. But it cannot maintain the entire history. After 10 years or 5 years, you need what is the basic salary of that employee, you need not get. So in OLAP, it can maintain the data and it is the ad hoc system. It will access the, or it, the usage of this is ad hoc. That is the main thing. And access means in OLTP, read, write, index, hash, and primary key, these are the available. For OLAP, lots of scans is required means, what is the meaning of that is, you need to get the particular required report, you must scan entire the data. So you can scan that data and you will finally get the information. That is the main thing. So here, so scans means first to last, you can analyze the data and you can take appropriate decisions. So before that, the first unit, we learn about the data mining. Data mining means, so knowledge discover. So what is the knowledge? Suppose if you are applying, it is a university database. You need to get the information greater than or equal to 75 students in the CSE. So that time, that is the required, that is the condition. According to that condition, you can scan each and every data and you will get the reports. So next, unit of work, short, simple transaction, that is OLAP. It is a complex work, OLAP. Why? Because in databases or in OLTP, very huge amount of data is there. In that huge amount of data, you need to apply short or simple transaction. But in OLAP, millions of the records is there. And that millions of the records is very complex query. Complex data, you need to write the queries and you need to retrieve the data. So for this purpose, we have so many tools is there. ETL tools. Extraction, transformation, loading. So in ETL tools, they are divided into some of the ETL tools, some of the reporting tools. For example, Informatica, Data Stage, those all are the ETL tools. And reporting tool, Cognos, Business Intelligence, these are the reporting tools. So information will be scanned with these tools also. And unit of work. Unit of work means it is simple and already explained, it is a complex. And records accessing. So in transactional process, only 10 records you need to access. Record access. But in the main data warehousing, so many thousands of the records. That means millions of the records is accessed. Millions of the records is accessed by the who? The top level management only accessed the complex records. So next, users. See, in OLTP, thousands of the users is there, but OLAP, hundreds of them. Why? Because this is 1,000 and this is only 100 means Already I told that it is used for the transaction analysis. This is used for the analysis the entire data. So analysis will be done by the top level management only, not for the general people. So that is the main important. So here users will be clerks or IT professional, any members will be used the transactional databases, but the analysis and take the decisions only with the top level management, like to the manager levels only they will take. That's why these are the very less. Suppose we have in our so many stores will be there. Take example of the Reliance store. Reliance stores is everywhere is there. Each and every store has the one manager will be there. So the managers will be getting, they are taking the decisions according to their stores. So like that, that's why this is for only analysis purpose, not for run the business. So that is very, very important. Two differences are very, very important. One is that it is maintain only detailed data, but OLAP maintain historical data. And the users is, it is used for the top level management only. Top level management will take the decision. That is very, very important. And this question is also very number of times they are asked in the exams. So you need to write all these points. You can get the good score. And next one, what is the size? So the size of the database is only 100 MB to GB, megabytes to gigabyte. But the starting of the this OLAP is 100 gigabytes to 1 terabyte also. So why? Because already I told the data warehouse, it is a collection of databases, huge amount of data is stored in this. Millions of records is there, not only single one. Just yesterday I explained the example. So in our Nellore district, over 4 or 5 colleges there. Chittur district, 4 or 5 colleges. Like that in JNT Anantapur, number of colleges will be there. You can take it as the JNT Anantapur database is the data warehouse. Each and any individual college has the one database. Like that you will take. So the size also data warehouse is very much, very huge amount of the size. But compared to the OLTP, OLTP is, it is a very small amount of data and it is used to transfer, run the business only. But OLAP means it is not used for run the business. It will take for the decisions only. Top level management will use it. So next you will matrix. How you can find out? Transaction throughput, query throughput, response. So what is this transaction throughput and query throughput means? Transactional means you can analysis each and every transaction, and according to the transaction you need to get the data. That is very, very important also. So here, see, next thing is, listen, so this is the differences. So now this is very, very important. So don't neglect this. This is very easy question also. Even though in your placement also, they will ask the difference between DA databases and data warehouse. So you need to explain this. So next. Anybody have doubts on this? Yeah, ask doubts. If you have any doubts, please ask everyone. Agnesri, Sai Charan, or any other remaining all participants. Anuhya, roll number 71, 77, Naveen, Surya, Deepak, Srihari, Pavan, Deepu, Sai Dharani, A2, Pavani. Ma, you have any doubts still? You can ask.
No doubt, sir.
Yeah, ma, time it will reduce. Again, you need to join. The same link you need to join. If it is closed, you need to join. Today, I need to explain some more topics. Sai Charan, if it is closed after 10 minutes, you need, again, you need to join all of you. The same link.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Go to the next topic here. And see, OLAP servers. Online analytical process. OLAP means, O means on, L means line, A means analytical, P means process, online analytical process. So there are four servers is there for online analytical process. One is the RO lab, MO lab, HO lab, specialized SQL server. So here, see. So RO lab means it is used for the relational databases. Relational databases means this relational data, relation between two tables is there. Those type of databases is used for the analysis purpose. And next one is multi-dimensional database. MO lab means multi-dimensional online analytical processing. Means here they are using the cube structure or multi-dimensional data. I will explain that using the diagrams, just wait. Hybrid OLAP, HOLAP means hybrid. Some is taken from the RDBMS, relational database. Some is taken from the multi-dimensional data, and both you can combine and take as the analysis purpose. That is called hybrid OLAP. And specialized SQL servers means they are used some servers, SQL servers, for the analysis purpose only. That is called the specialized SQL servers, OLAP server. That is very, very important. RO lab versus MO lab. This is asked for 2 marks. And suppose they asked for the 6 marks also, you need to write a diagram and you need to explain. See, I will show the diagram now. See, this is, see here, you can observe my, in this first one, RDBMS. Here they are using the relational database management databases. So for that databases, they need to get the relational online analytical process. They are getting the reports. So these relational databases are directly used for the analysis purpose. They will directly take the reports. That is the meaning of it. And multi-dimensional means cubic structure. Already I told that this data warehousing is stored in the multi-dimensional way and cubic structure. Next question, I will explain about the cube, how the cube is stored, how we will get the one slicing of the information and all, we will explain. So this cubic structure, we need to get the data, and that will be explained with multi-dimensional online analytical processing, generate the reports. So next and the third one, hybrid online analytical process. Hybrid means you can take the data from relational databases and you can take the data from cubical structure, database and data warehouse. You will take the data from those two and you can combine with the hybrid OLAP servers, and finally you can generate the reports. This is called the HOLAP, hybrid online analytical processing. So this is used for the top level managements, and they will take the decisions. That is also one of the things. And next one is, so why separate data warehousing? Actually we have each and every database of the each and every organization have one database. Why again you need another databases? That is the main question. So here already we know DBMS turned for OLTP, access method, indexing, concurrency control, recovery. For this purpose, they are maintaining a small amount of data. Warehouses means it is a complex query process, multi-dimensional view. You can view any of the one, any slicing, you can get the information. And millions of the records you need to store. No need to worry about the memory. If it is stored, how we can get the retrieval, and no need to worry about all this. You can write the query, or if you are using that ETL tools, very easily you will get the reports. So in ETL process, ETL tools are used for 80% and reporting tools are used for 20%. This 20% is also very difficult after converting all the data into that 80% work. This 20% work is also very, very important in real time, because they will take the decisions using that reports only. That is the main thing. Next one. So different data warehousing. Suppose missing data is there. If any data is missing in the databases, we cannot get it back. But in data warehousing, it can maintain the history. Suppose any data is missing, so you go and take the data from the history. And data consolidations. So different data, heterogeneous data, you can get the different data. From the heterogeneous databases, you can get the data. And you can integrate those data and you will get the reports. That is the one thing. And data quality is also, already I told that in pre-processing, data cleaning, the quality of data, noisy data, inconsistency data, incorrect data will be eliminated at the process. And high quality data is stored into the data warehouses. That is the main thing. Next. So this is the about the data warehousing and data warehousing OLAP servers and difference between OLTP versus OLAP, operational data warehouse and data warehousing definition. So a data warehousing is a subject oriented, integrated and time variant non-volatile database. So here it is used for that purpose only. It is used to analyze this purpose only, not for run the business. Okay, anybody have any doubts now? Up to till you have any doubts, please ask. $599, CR, Ruchita, Anokya, Lavanya Sri, Navi, Sudeep, Devasena. You have any doubts, ask me, I will explain. So this is very, very important. You know about these basics. Depending upon the basics only, everything is defined, our clustering, classification. So you need to learn all these definitions and all. Next we will discuss about the architecture of a data warehouse system. Sai Dharani, M. Pavani, Mubin, Praveen, Lakshmi Prasad, Jagadish, Srihari, Surya, you have any doubts, ask. Okay, it is now less than 1 minute is there. After completion of this, again rejoin to the same link. You have any doubts, you can ask, no problem.